Find out tonight.
Broadcast, but here at the top of the program, I must inform all of our great fans on the status of the world's heavyweight champion Sting. Recently in the Omni, in a match for the world's title with Big Van Vader, Sting suffered broken ribs, a bruised sternum. He was rushed to the hospital. He's going to be out of action, it looks like, until about May the 17th, when he will hopefully return to action at the big WrestleWar pay-per-view. But Sting is really battered, really banged up. We'll talk more about that situation in this hour. But now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like for everyone here in our studio and all of you at home to please welcome my guest co-host for the evening. He was a three-time football All-American at the University of Pittsburgh, a member of the All-NFL team of the 1980s, Sports Illustrated Rookie of the Year. He's number 79 of the Atlanta Falcons. Please welcome All-Pro guard Bill Frelick to WCW Saturday Night. Being here. I really appreciate you being here. We've got an outstanding program, and I know you're a big fan of WCW. We should have a lot of fun here tonight.
Well, I'll tell you, Jim, it's my honor to be here. I've been a big fan of WCW for a long time and been a friend of yours, obviously, and I'll tell you, I'm looking forward to the evening.
Fans, we got a big main event. It's for the television championship of the world. It will be decided in 2 out of 3 falls. Barry Windham will challenge stunning Steve Austin. Let's hear comments from both competitors.
Steve Austin, you've become a puppet of Paulie Dangerously and the Dangerous Alliance. Now, you stepped into a situation when my hand was crushed in the car door, and you were there at the wrong time because Paulie Dangerously set the whole thing up. Now, tonight, I am going to give you the wrestling lesson of your life, and that World Television Championship that you cherish so very much is going to be mine because I have set a goal for myself, and I'm going to destroy the Dangerous Alliance.
Tonight, right here on WCW Saturday Night, it's time for Barry Windham to finally learn his lesson. The Dangerous Alliance has toyed with you and toyed with you and toyed with you. And tonight, setting Steve Austin 2 out of 3 falls is going to finish off the job.
You know, I told the world a few weeks ago that I would be the greatest world television champion ever. And that I am the best wrestler on TV today. And Barry Windham, I'm going to prove that to you not once, but twice. You'll see.
Both those men are ready. You'll see that match right here from our studios here a little bit later in the hour. Bill, the Falcons had a great year last year. They went to the playoffs. You won your first round game against the New Orleans Saints. This year, you'll be competing in the new Georgia Dome right beside the Omni, the home of WCW. But how do you see the football forecast for this season?
Well, I'll tell you what, Jim, we're coming off a great year, and I'd like to think we're going to have an even better one next year. But we got a lot of unsettled situations right now. You got Deion Sanders contemplating baseball and other things, and you know, right now my situation is unclear too. I've got a contract that I've got to settle with the Falcons, and one of the reasons I'm here, to tell you the truth, is to explore the option of wrestling here at WCW.
Very big news. You're seriously considering wrestling in WCW if things don't work out for the Falcons?
Well, I'll tell you what, it's not necessarily if they do work out with the Falcons. I'm just exploring all my options. I think the thing with professional wrestling and professional football is such that, hey, you've got to be big, strong, fast, and aggressive, and I think those qualities have made me a good professional football player, and I think they'll also make me a good professional wrestler if I choose to do that.
This fall, he could be competing in the Georgia Dome, or he could be competing right next door in the Omni. Fans, we're going to be back. We'll take a look at Scotty Flamingo next on WCW Saturday Night. Welcome back, everyone, to WCW Saturday Night. Jim Ross and Bill Frelick back with you. In just a few moments, we'll go to the ring to see two top light heavyweights in action, Scotty Flamingo and Firebreaker Chip in one-on-one competition. But before we go to the ring, I want you to hear some comments made earlier today by Scotty Flamingo. And Bill, what are your impressions of this young man?
Well, I'll tell you what, he reminds me a lot of my teammate, Deion Sanders. When he came out of college a couple years ago, he talked a lot and said he was going to do all this. Well, he's done everything that he said he was going to do. Scotty remains to be seen. He's got the talk, but does he have the walk?
He's a great athlete. At least he says he's going to be the next light heavyweight champion. This should be an outstanding contest, and we'll go to the ring. But first, these comments.
Well, you know, 21 years old, from Palm Beach, Florida, incredibly, or should I say, filthy rich parents, graduated University of Miami, law degree, pre-law degree, business degree, never worked a day in my life, and I don't think I ever would. In fact, I know I never would. Now, the point is, a lot of you are saying, well, you're spoiled rotten, never worked a day in your life. Can you take it in the ring? Well, don't misunderstand me. There ain't a wrestler out there that I can't take their cranium and turn it into a flower pot, because I'm Scotty Flamingo, the fresh thing in town. Listen to this rhyme, because I'm going to throw down. If you don't like me and you feel kind of froggy, jump in my face, I'll leave you groggy.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back. Those comments pre-recorded from Scotty Flamingo. He'll take on Firebreaker Chip here on WCW Saturday Night. Drop toe by Scotty Flamingo, a young man that obviously possesses a great deal of self-confidence. Still to come in this broadcast. TV Championship matchup. There's a roll-up and an ear fall by Firebreaker Chip. And my friend Bill Frenick and I will still be talking to Nikita Koloff. And I certainly hope that Mr. Koloff will take this opportunity today to let us all know exactly his motives for returning to WCW. Flamingo with the advantage, side headlock. Firebreaker Chip, the stronger of the two. Nice drop kick. And Flamingo rolling out of bounds. But here comes Chip. And caught him with another drop kick here on the outside. Lion Brian Pillman, the WCW light heavyweight champion, certainly has a long and talented list of challenges, not only here in WCW, but around the world. Irish Whip. Firebreaker Chip for the monkey flip, bringing Scotty Flamingo outside. And right now, Chip is controlling the tempo. Nice reversal. Scotty Flamingo tries the move, and Chip landed right on his feet. Great agility, follows it with a clothesline, lateral press, and a near fall. Another drop kick, as Chip has used that move frequently in this contest. Fans, don't forget that WCW returns to center stage this Monday night in Atlanta. Another taping of WCW Saturday Night, as Flamingo executes the double arm suplex. Lateral press. You notice he did not neutralize the legs, thus allowing Chip to kick out. We're excited that the lead singer for the honored country music group Alabama, Randy Owen, will be with us at center stage this Monday as a guest co-host for an upcoming WCW Saturday Night broadcast. Many of the WCW stars will be participating in Alabama's June Jam. We'll be talking more about that. But Randy Owen of Alabama will be with us at center stage this Monday night, 7 o'clock, and tickets are free. Another near fall situation by Firebreaker Chip, and Scotty Flamingo beat the Firebreaker to his feet. Breaking the eyes very blatantly. Snap mare, and down goes the Firebreaker. Flamingo now showing some staunch offense, but he's a little hesitant, and that cover will not get it. I don't think he could pin Randy Anderson with that move, and Anderson weighs 145. Power drive elbows by Scotty Flamingo, who says that emphatically, without any doubt in his mind, that he will be the next WCW light heavyweight champion. And Firebreaker Chip got the fists up and caught him again coming in. We're going to be participating with Bill Frelick on Friday, May 15th, the first annual Bill Frelick Celebrity Golf Tournament in Philadelphia. Good power slam by Firebricker Chip and a near fall. I'll tell you more on that in the hour. Irish whip to the near side and a back body drop by Chip the Firebricker. Been a very evenly fought contest thus far. He set too early, and Flamingo tried to get him in the pile driver. Chip too strong. Irish whip. Here comes the Firebricker. And nobody home that time. Flamingo able to move out of the way, and now can he capitalize? Trying to get him up? Yes, he can. A sudden pile driver. And this one's over.
Here is your winner, Scotty Flamingo!
Flamingo with a victory. And now let's go to Eric Bischoff.
Thanks, Jim. And this is the WCW Magazine for April 25th, 1992. Our lead story concerns an injury to the WCW World's Heavyweight Champion, Sting. In a world title match at the Omni Coliseum, Sting suffered broken and bruised ribs when he was power slammed off the top turnbuckle by 450-pound Van Vader. Now, what's truly ironic about this situation is that rather than covering Sting and becoming the new World Heavyweight Champion, Van Vader continued his rage and went after the referee, causing him to be disqualified. Now, it's unclear at this time how this injury is going to affect Sting's ability to participate in War Games coming up May 17th. We will be hearing from Sting tomorrow on the main event here on TBS, and we hope to get an update at that time. Meanwhile, Van Vader is standing by with his comments on the situation.
The legend of Sting is over. The myth the WCW calls Sting is through. Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce myself, for I am the uncrowned WCW heavyweight champion of the world. Sting, we talked about pain. Sting, we talked about going to school and learning the game of pain. Well, brother, how does it feel? I understand you went to the hospital, Sting. Did it hurt? I understand you cried, Sting. Did it hurt? Who else does the WCW have to offer for Vader?
Well, those comments from the man that broke the ribs of the world's heavyweight champion. And as I said, we will be hearing from Sting tomorrow on the main event. And no doubt this development could have a devastating effect on Sting's squadron at War Games. Well, another great match has been announced for WrestleWar 92. The United States Tag Team titles are on the line May 17th when Greg Valentine and the TaylorMade Man meet the challenge of the Freebirds. The United States Tag Team Champions are standing by.
Hammer, you hear anything? Yeah, I don't hear anything either. I don't hear our knees knocking. Michael P.S. Hayes opened that big yap of his, told us what he's going to do. Jimmy Garvin's going, yeah, yeah, do it, Michael. You're going to do it. Yeah, one of you's scared and the other one's glad of it. You'll never get these.
Who do you boys think you're talking to? Or I should say, who do you birds think you're talking to? All you're worried about is music. You better be worried about wrestling. You better be worried about winning these titles, which you'll never do.
And you can be a part of all the excitement when you call your local cable operator and order WrestleWar 92 live only on pay-per-view. Well, last week, Jim Ross caught up with Diamond Dallas Page and tried to get his reaction to the fact that Page was banned from making any comments directly related to WCW policy. Well, Page's mouth got him into trouble again. As a result, he has been banned from any televised appearances outside of the wrestling ring by K. Allen Fry. Now, our cameras were on hand when Page received notification of this development. Now, this footage has been cleared for broadcast by WCW Executive Vice President K. Allen Fry.
What? 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 K. Allen Fry says I can't be on TV? You! This K. Allen Fry! You gotta be great!
The most dangerous mouth in WCW reduced to a test pattern tone. Music to my ears. Well, before we leave you, Louise Gleason from Leavittsburg, Ohio, left this question for Stunning Steve Austin on the Full Menu Hotline. Stunning Steve Austin, why don't you leave the Dangerous Alliance and wrestle by the rules?
Louise, you silly bag. Haven't you been paying attention? Don't you know that I am the world television champion? If you're going to ask me about rules, I'll tell you this. I wrestle by my rules. I haven't been fined. I haven't been suspended or stripped of the title. That's a stupid question.
That answer from stunning Steve Austin. I'm Eric Bischoff, reminding you to keep up to date on all the action happening in WCW with your own personal copy of the WCW magazine, available on newsstands nationwide. Jim Ross and Bill Frelick return with a very special guest, Nikita Koloff, right after this timeout.
Ladies and gentlemen, for WCW Saturday Night, Jim Ross and Bill Frelick of the Atlanta Falcons back with you. Ladies and gentlemen, a tremendous cloud of mystery has surrounded our next guest. A lot of questions have gone unanswered. We hope to get those answers here in this hour. Please welcome, ladies and gentlemen, here in our studio, and those of you watching at home, Nikita Koloff to WCW Saturday Night. Thanks for being with us. Please make yourself comfortable. You know, Bill, ever since we found out that you were going to be on the broadcast and that Nikita was going to be our guest, I know you've got a big question to address to Nikita Koloff here at the outset.
First of all, I'd like to say it's a pleasure to meet you. I've been a big fan of yours, but I think the thing that got in my mind when I knew I was going to be here, and I'm sure it's in everybody else's mind, is what are you doing here? I've been following this for weeks now, and I'd like to put you on the spot and say, Nikita Koloff, why are you back in the WCW?
Well, let me say, my friend, first, that it has also been a pleasure in watching you in your career in football, as I have done. I have watched you, and that's exactly what I'm here for tonight, is to answer the question.
You know, Nikita, a lot of us have a hard time perhaps trusting you and your motives. I'd like to take us back and remember what happened at the very first Wrestle War. That was in Phoenix, Arizona. You appeared on the scene during an interview, and it was basically, what in the eyes of many, a cheap shot on then the United States champion.
Good grief!
Well, as though there were many out there who were booing me, there were many, many more, Jim Ross, who were cheering me. Because I've got to believe those people who were cheering me knew what I knew about Lex Luger, and that was that he didn't care about signing the fans' autographs. He didn't care about shaking the fans' hands. He cared about one thing and one thing only, and that was he cared about himself.
Well, I can understand that point, and I can certainly agree with that. But then at the very first Super Brawl, that was in St. Petersburg, Florida, you returned to the ring again. And if I recall, you had a chain wrapped around your arm. You came to the ring, and Sting suffered the force of your blow.
That's true. However, as is very clear to see, my motive that night was, again, for Lex Luger and Lex Luger only. I said right at the very start, Jim Ross, that Sting was in the wrong place at the wrong time. But I will say this for Sting. I will say this for Sting. I have nothing but the utmost respect for Sting, because, let me say, because with him coming back after me that night, he proved that he not only had a lot of guts, but he proved he also had a lot of intestinal fortitude to stand up, and for that reason, I have a lot of respect for him.
Well, I can understand that as well, but then, because of what happened at that Super Bowl, you and Sting got involved in a very intense physical feud. It looked as if one of the other would end the other's career. But in the midst of this feud, you disappeared.
I disappeared from WCW for two reasons. The first reason has to do with my homeland of Lithuania. It's very public knowledge that at that time they were fighting for their freedom. My friends, my family back home in Lithuania were fighting for their freedom. Just like the freedom in this great country that everybody here has. And I know. Huh? Okay? The second reason, Jim, the second reason I left WCW had to do with what happened last year in Knoxville, Tennessee.
Well, I want to tell you something. In regard to the Knoxville, Tennessee incident, I was at ringside, and Sting was holding a little stinger by the name of Ben. And I know from the look on your face that you scared that young man. He thought you were going to strike him. He had fear in his eyes.
I realize that, and I have to say there has been two things that have happened in my life that have been very instrumental. The first happened in October of 1986, as a lot of people know and some maybe don't know, and that was when Magnum T.A. went down in a car accident and ended his career. Well, Magnum was probably one of the toughest opponents I'd ever faced in my lifetime. But a man pulled me aside, and he changed my life forever. And of course, I'm talking about the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. He changed my life forever. Let me just say, the second thing that happened was what you're talking about, Big Ben. And I don't know what to say. I don't know what came over me that night. I don't know what I was thinking, but I do know this, Jim Ross. I have talked to Big Ben several times by telephone. I have flown to Knoxville, and I have sat down in Big Ben's home, and Big Ben and I have now become best of friends.
Well, that's great to hear that. A situation, though, must be addressed, and I think that's the reason that we're all here. You then reappeared at Super Brawl. Why were you at Super Brawl, sir?
The big question, why was Nikita Koloff at Super Brawl? Well, I was at Super Brawl because I wanted to talk to Sting. And as is very obvious, as everybody knows, because of what the Dangerous Alliance did, I never got the opportunity to talk to Sting. And for that reason, up to this day, I still have not had the opportunity to talk to Sting. That's why I was at Super Brawl. Okay?
So this is, I'm sure Sting is watching this broadcast right now. He's injured.
Well, I want to say this to you, Sting. I know you're out there listening. It really saddens me to see what Big Van Vader has done for you. Or I should say to you, I'm sorry. But I want to say this. Sting, I want to say this. Anytime, any place, night, day, I don't care. I'm only a phone call away, my friend. If you need me, I'll be there.
I'm sure that's going to uplift Sting's spirits in a time of need. So the youngsters have really affected your life.
The Stingers have really made a tremendous impact. In fact, if I may, I'd like to bring a special friend out right now, if I could.
Of course, no problem.
Taryn, come on over here, honey.
Kita's got a young friend.
Jim Ross, what Taryn represents here is, she represents, come on, huh? Here for Taryn, huh? What Taryn represents here is Big Ben in Knoxville and all the Stingers out there, little, big, black, white, green, I don't care what color you are, I don't care how old or how young you are, Taryn represents all those Sting fans out there. Taryn, if I may, I'd like to ask you a question, if I could.
Sure.
Okay. I want you looking right in that camera over there, okay? And I want you to tell all these people here and the whole world who your all-time favorite wrestler is.
Sting.
Well, Sting, I've got a message too, Sting. You're my favorite too, buddy. And I'd like to say one more thing, Jim Ross, before I go. And that is I'd like to say something to K. Allen Fry. K. Allen Fry, let me say this. Anytime, anywhere, I don't care, Nikita Koloff will sign the dotted line to meet Big Van Vader. Anytime.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, there you hear it. Nikita Koloff, heartfelt remarks, and we'll be right back. From Nikita Koloff, so heartfelt and very sincere. We know his intentions right now. We're going to try to hear from the Stinger, and we'll hope to have word on that a little bit later in this broadcast. But right now, we're going to go back to the ring to see Arn Anderson in one-on-one competition. Bill, I know you followed Arn Anderson's career for quite some time. What are your thoughts on this athlete?
Well, I'll tell you what, Jim. He's the kind of guy that if I were an NFL coach, I'd like to build my defense around. He reminds you of the prototype of a middle linebacker. You know, he is tough. He's aggressive, and he knows what he's doing, and he'll lead people, and he'll follow them. He's in an individual sport right now, and I think that He's the kind of guy who's going to show up every night and do what it takes. And he might not be the most popular guy out there, but he's definitely one of the best.
He indeed is that. One half of the World Tag Team Champions, Arn Anderson. Let's go to the ring now, ladies and gentlemen, and see Arn Anderson in one-on-one competition.
And the bell has sounded as Arn Anderson and Larry Santo here on WCW Saturday Night. Quick reminder, we hope you'll join us this Monday night at Center Stage for another taping of this broadcast. Randy Owen of the music group Alabama will be with us as Arn Anderson nails Santo from behind. And quickly, we'll also be in Birmingham, Alabama. That'll be this Tuesday night. Big event in Birmingham Tuesday night. Both those events, Monday at Center Stage and Tuesday in Birmingham, start at 7 o'clock. Arn Anderson with a powerful knee drop to Santo. And WCW's version of Cy Sperling on the outside. I hope we don't shoot his ball spot because it certainly offends him. Back heel trip. Anderson, one half of the World Tag Team Champions. One of the toughest athletes in WCW history. There's no doubt about that. He is a very accomplished athlete in tag teams or in single competition. We don't need a mic dangerously. We've let him do the running commentary from ringside. Any opportunity he gets to talk, he'll take it. There's no doubt about that. Anderson and Eaton, of course, have had their share of problems with the Steiner brothers. Steiner brothers bowing to WCW and their fans that they will regain the World Tag Team Championship. They have been unable to accomplish that as of yet. We mentioned earlier that on Friday, May 15th, Kay Allen Fry, Jesse the Body Ventura, and yours truly will be in Pittsburgh to participate in the Bill Friendly Celebrity Golf Tournament. Bill does a lot of great work in the charities, and he's doing something for his home community there in Penn Hills, right outside of Pittsburgh. And Anderson, and this has a submission maneuver on Santo. May just be a matter of time here. Looking forward to tomorrow's broadcast in the main event. We are anxious to hear what Sting has to say about what Nikita Koloff has said here in this hour about his injury situation with Big Van Vader. And there it is, Spinebuster. So Sting will be on the main event tomorrow. Special interview. And this one is in the book, fans.
Here is your winner, Arn Anderson.
Arn Anderson, who will take on Big Josh right here next Saturday on WCW Saturday Night. Fans, this will be our Castrol High Performance of the Week. Castrol is engineered for today's smaller cars, and we'll be back. Welcome back, everyone, to WCW Saturday Night. It's time now for our big 2 out of 3 fall main event for the television championship. Barry Windham to challenge Stunning Steve Austin. And Bill Frederick, how do you see this one?
Well, I'll tell you what, Jim, it reminds me of an old-fashioned football game. Two teams are going to go at each other. These two individuals, I think, are going to try and beat one another up, not take too many chances, and let the chips fall where they may. And I think I'm going to lay my bet on Windham.
Fans, it's going to be a great main event. Let's go up to our good friend, Rhubarb Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is for the WCW World TV title. And it's set for 2 out of 3 falls or television title remaining. Introducing the challenger at 273 pounds from Sweetwater, Texas, Barry Windham.
Ladies and gentlemen, while we have a moment, don't forget, we'll return to Center Stage this Monday night for another taping of WCW Saturday Night. Big event in Birmingham, Alabama this Tuesday night, and then this Friday night in St. Petersburg, Florida at the Bayfront Arena. Jesse the Body Ventura will be there. Tremendous week of action ahead here at WCW. Now let's go back up to Rhubarb.
Introducing the World TV Champion at 258 pounds from Hollywood, California,
be a great mat wrestling event because both these guys like to mat wrestle. As you mentioned, they're not going to want to make any mistakes because the stakes in this one are extremely high. The man that wins this match, the television champion, is considered to be the best wrestler on television. So this is a great challenge for Wyndham and for Stunning Steve Austin.
Well, I realize that Wyndham's going to take the belt from, and that's an uphill battle, but I think my money is still on Wyndham.
The bell has sounded for our first fall here. As Rhubarb Jones mentioned, this match, 2 out of 3 falls for television time remaining. And Paul E. Dangerously, not very popular here in the studio. Collar and elbow tie up and a little test of strength here in the early going. And I would think that Wyndham would have an advantage perhaps, Bill, in strength and in leverage.
Well, I think that leverage is the key thing there, Jim. He's got more leverage than Austin, and that's going to make him stronger than he actually is. And I didn't see anything to change my mind about that yet.
Good headlock takeover and a near fall there by Barry Wyndham. Wyndham, a second-generation wrestler, knows what it's like to wear championship belts. Football tackle. Wyndham, who played some college football at West Texas State, and a lot of great ones came out of West Texas, including not only the gridiron, Mercury Morris and Dwayne Thomas, but also great wrestlers like Dusty Rhodes and the Funk Brothers. So he's got a great background, and he seems to be real focused in this as well.
The way he's tossing around there, it looks like Lawrence Taylor throwing a few quarterbacks around. You can tell he's got some football background in there.
Stunning Steve Austin has been the WCW television champion for quite some time, and many people consider him to be the greatest television champion ever in WCW. Another headlock takeover. And Austin complaining that the hair was pulled. I didn't see that, Bill. Did you?
I didn't see that either, and I didn't see any hair being pulled here. I just saw feet flying and butts landing.
Wyndham controlling the action here and controlling the tempo with that side headlock. He's 6'6". And as Bill Frelick mentioned, leverage has a major role in any athletic event. Wyndham has that advantage in this one, as we documented. Another good football block by Barry Wyndham, and the challenger going to the far side, but he's caught in the midsection by Stunning Steve Austin. Austin now with a front face lock, trying to suplex Wyndham, but that move trying to be countered, and neither man could gain an advantage there.
I'll tell you, that leverage we talked about played an important part in him keeping him from getting him up off the ground, and there you can see Mr. Dangerously trying to interfere as usual.
Is Dangerously anything like Jerry Glanville?
Well, I wouldn't put Dangerously in anybody's class right now. I'll tell you what, Jerry Glanville knows what he's doing, and I will give Dangerously credit. He does know how to handle these wrestlers and keep them on top.
Collar and elbow tie up again. Barry Wyndham with the advantage. Another headlock takeover, and Austin counters into the head scissors. Fans complaining that Austin pulled the hair that time. Wyndham trying to find a way from this head scissors. Oh, big right hand. Wyndham with a big time right hand.
That looked like an old Deacon Jones head slap there.
And Austin felt that one. If Jones was a member of the Fearsome Foursome, then Wyndham is a member of the Terrible Five. Those five knuckles right on his head. And Austin really complaining here to referee Mike Atkins. This time Austin rakes the eyes. And now he'll try to gain an advantage.
Yeah, so tough.
Austin rams Wyndham's face into the top turnbuckle, sends him for the ride across the ring, and caught him with the elbow there. Wyndham has had so many problems with the Dangerous Alliance. They broke his hand. He's been in some tremendous wars with Dustin Rhodes. There's a suplex. He's got the leg hook, and he got it. He got it. Executed a suplex. And Bill, we'll take another look at this. Wyndham again with a great leverage advantage right there is a good example.
I'll tell you, Jim, my bet's looking pretty good right now. I think I'm going to win out in the end there. Too bad we're not in Vegas.
Wyndham's got to win one more fall to be the television champion, and we'll be back right after this timeout. And the bell has sounded, and we're back, ladies and gentlemen. Jim Ross and Atlanta Falcon Bill Fredrick back here on WCW Saturday night. And in this 2-out-of-3-fall match, Barry Windham is up 1-fall to none. Windham needs to win one more fall to win the World Television Championship. So it is a must-win fall here for Stunning Steve Austin. Already the fourth quarter for Austin, because he's got to win this fall to even it up. On the other hand, Windham's got to win the fall to walk away with the championship.
His back is against the wall, Jim. I'd keep my eye out if I were Barry Windham for Mr. Dangerously over there. He's capable of interfering.
That is certainly his modus operandi. But right now, Barry Windham
is taking a chance here.
And Dangerously tried a cheap shot there. And, oh, Austin got a right hand in. Windham's attention was focused on Dangerously. And now the momentum. And old Mo has such a big part to play in any athletic event. Bill, I know when the Falcons get hot with their red gun offense, momentum is such a big part of your offensive success for the Falcons. And Austin now trying to build that momentum in this championship match.
Well, we talked about these two individuals not taking chances, and that Dangerously could interfere and cause the momentum to change. Well, there you saw Barry went up and took a chance, and Dangerously got involved, and you end up getting burned. These are things we talked about early, and it seems like it's coming true to some point here.
Irish whip to the far side. He caught him the clothesline. Austin with a high-impact move there. Really up. Keeping it in a smash mouth level. Another right hand. Windham over the top rope. Now, if he had thrown him over, it would have been a disqualification. But it's a judgment call, much like pass interference, Bill, in football. So the match will continue, and Windham is dazed.
Momentum is definitely turned here.
Austin's World Television Championship is on the line. Exclusively here on WCW Saturday night. Fans, I'll have an update on the Stinger on the wrestling hotline until midnight tonight. We'll let you know how he's feeling and his thoughts on what we've heard from Nikita Koloff in this broadcast. And don't forget, Sting will be making a statement tomorrow on the main event. Oh, Windham on the outside. So we hope you'll tune in with Tony Schiavone, Magnum TA, and Missy Hyatt tomorrow for the main event here on TBS, and we'll hear some comments from the Stinger. Windham having to really reach down now.
I think I can hedge my bet now, Jim.
I think
too late.
He made a commitment. I think he's got a, he's ahead one fall and none here. He's got a, and he can win one fall. It takes 3 seconds, as you and the fans know, so doesn't take long to change the complexion here. But Austin's doing all he can to prevent Windham from any offensive maneuvers. It's kind of like Windham's on playing defense now. The defense is on the field for a long, long time.
I'll tell you, Jim, he's getting worn down now. If he's got to go another match here, I'll tell you, this is going to play a factor in that.
Austin with a snap mare. And the reverse chin lock.
2 minutes television time remaining.
You heard the call from Rhubarb Jones. We don't have a great deal of television wrestling time remaining. And it puts Barry Windham in a very precarious position, because he has to win one more fall before time expires, and Austin with a takedown. So the clock is now an ally of Stunning Steve Austin.
Austin can be conservative here and kill the clock, if you will, by grounding it out, as I talked about earlier. And I'll tell you what, it doesn't look good for Barry right now, but he's going to make something happen. And here's another high-risk move.
And Austin took a chance that did not pay off. And now let's see if Windham can capitalize. Dangerously did not want Austin to take that chance. And Windham, with time running out here, must win this fall. Oh, my God.
1 minute. 1 minute TV time remaining.
I think those guys needed helmets on that one, Jim. I'll tell you what. It's amazing that they're still breathing after that
45
collision.
45 seconds television time remaining.
45 seconds remaining. Windham going for the cover. And he got 2.5. A half a count away from a new television champion being crowned. Windham now hooking both arms. Taking Austin down. Pinning
30 seconds television time.
And another 2.5. We're inside 30 seconds here on WCW Saturday Night. Windham caught him with a lariat. This may be it. A new champion may be crowned here in Austin. We got the foot on the rope.
15 seconds television time remaining.
He's got to let it loose.
Windham's got to go for broke here.
10 seconds remaining.
Windham trying the suplex.
6.
That's how he won the first fall.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh, no. He came a half a count away. Let's go to Rhubarb and the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, television time has expired. No wrestler has won 2 falls. Thus, Stunning Steve Austin retains the World TV title.
Big Bill, I want to thank you for being with us. I'm still very intrigued about what you said earlier. The Falcons are wrestling. It's going to be a big decision for you to make later on this summer.
Well, I'll tell you what, it's a good option to have, and I'll tell you, after watching this up close and personal, I'll tell you what, I'd have my work cut out coming in here competing against these guys, but I'll tell you what, I'd look forward to it if it ever did work out.
Fans, those comments from Bill Frelick, don't forget to join us on the main event tomorrow. I'm Jim Ross saying so long, everybody.